Hello, Mel speaking. Hold on a second. What do you mean, live snakes? Where? In her checked-in baggage? All right. I'm on my way, hun. I'm there. I'm coming down. All right. Bye. I'm following you. This is new for me.
No, you discovered today something.
Yes.
Snakes?
Oh! Are they eggs? Those are eggs, right?
The scans show the cases are packed with snakes and eggs. These cases are alive. This large case contains a huge snake.
Oh my gosh. I'm just curious to know, we've got the other baggage that belongs to the same passengers, so I'm just curious to know what's been packed in those bags. Maybe there'll be another surprise, who knows? Oh my gosh. And what's in here? Oh, that's an. Oh! That's upset me, that has.
The cases are full of monkeys, and there are even kittens in there, likely destined to be fed to the snakes.
No, no, of course not. This has to be declared via customs and everything. We need certificates.
Live animals can only be transported legally with the correct paperwork and in proper containers. And if the animals are an endangered species, the maximum punishment in Dubai is up to 6 months in jail and a fine of over $10,000.
Let's go. It's absolutely heart-wrenching. I hate to think how those animals are feeling. All I can hear is the crying, so I don't really want to look. I think everybody's feeling the same. It's not a nice situation at all. It's inhumane, actually.
Any item of luggage that has disputed ownership is a massive security risk. And coupled with the animal trafficking, Mel has only one option, to hand over the matter to the Dubai police.
Although the passenger's suggesting that she tried to help another passenger with excess baggage, ultimately, she checked in those bags. The baggage receipts are under her name. And again, he said if it had been any illegal substances, it's very easy for people to turn around and say, I checked it in for somebody else. So they are going to pursue a case in this instance.